And the presentation, the name is audiovisual cues to switch attention. And we know that for human brains, we got eyes, we see things, and we got ears, we hear things. And human brains do not deal with those two modalities in isolation. In contrast, human brains interconnect those signals because they have some certain relationship to each other. And we know that if we sound something very, very bizarre and like murder, and then we will pay attention to that. And at the same time, if we see something is very weird, and also we want to pay attention to that, this is very simple and for human brains, but for machines, this task is extremely difficult. And our project aims to mimic such abilities with machines. And this is the work scope of our project, and here we get some work in psychology work and some audio input and some visual input, and the structure is like this. And for the psychology input, and first we did lots of literature reviews and we analyzed lots of data, and we noticed that if we found some keywords that for a machine need to pay attention to. For example, if we hear those words like a car bomb, like suicide bomber, and then this needs to be taken care of. And also for the visual cues, these are quite interesting, and also we need to extract those out, that including the gestures and the facial expressions and content analysis. And for our visual part, we focused on these facial expressions, that is to analyze the emotion of a guy from the video signals. And this psychology input will work as the guideline of our other work. And for the audio part of this project, the work is focused on to extract the keywords from a continuous speech signals. And for example, from these signals, we don't want to care about the other words, but when we suddenly hear this word, combo, and we need to extract it out. And of course, these keywords can be defined by us. And another problem is that we don't want to train the data, and also the keywords may become different with time, so we can change the keywords whenever we like. And also, these keywords extraction must from continuous speech. It's not for the isolated word recognition. So this work is a little difficult. And after that, our audio input and the visual input will work closely together. After we hear from the audio input, we hear some keywords, and then we will record the timing of that, and then send this to the visual streams. And then the video signal, we will analyze the video signals to get the emotion of that person. Okay. Before we do our research, we first recorded some data for testing, and we prepared 17 pairs of fake criminal or non-criminal sentences, and for each pair of these sentences, they contain some keywords like recruitment, like target, but for one of them, it will be non-criminal, and for the others, will be criminal. This will be used for test. Here is one example. And
give the recruitment agency a call and see what work they have.
And our aim is to extract this keyword recruitment from that video signals and then get the timing to the video input. Sorry for this. Yes, and
Okay, here comes come to our work. And first, for the audio part, our work is to spot the keywords from continuous speech. And we want to realize those things. First, it must be in real time. And then it must from continuous speech. And also, we don't want to spend a lot of time on the training data. And so, also, we can define the keywords, whatever we want. So that's our aims. And our solution is to use a forward hidden microwave models and using HTK acoustic models. The acoustic models is like that. We suppose the speech signals are composed by words, and each word is composed by different forms, and each form can be modeled by one hidden microwave model. And since we don't need some, we just want to extract the keywords. We don't want to analyze the whole sentence, so we don't need the language models. And for example, if we want to extract the word carbon from this sentence, that's how we do it. And from those previous sentences, there's no carbon there, so we don't care about that. But from these frames, this sounds like the form car, and this will sound like the word car, and this is silence, and then the next frame will be the form b, and if the next frame will be still b or o, then we continue to search until the next frame comes. Otherwise, we will think that there's no carbon in these audio signals. And we generate some simple demos to demonstrate this process. And here is one continuous speech, and it is DAO 637810. And for example, now we define the keyword as 3. Here is how we found it. Now we get a 6. So did I press another one? Okay. For example, here we want to find 6. It comes to the next video already. I don't know what happened to the software, but if you notice, there's some red labels there, and when that word, the keywords we defined, is spoken, it will show there. We can see this red label. For example, this is 7.
Seven.
Here it comes, so we find it.
810.
And also, we can get any keywords we want.
837 810.
Okay. And all we need is to define the keyword and its pronunciation. Of course, we don't need to write input this. We can just download some dictionary online and search the dictionary of the word we want to find to get it. Okay. And after the audio in audio analysis to find the keywords we wanted to define, we give the time of that words and transfer that to the visual signals, to the visual analyzers. And in our visual signal processing, we do things like that. We get the facial image out, and for one or two frames from the previous timing, we analyze the emotion of the speaker, and the output will be like sad, happy, funny, disgust, things like that. And we also did some work on the facial micro expressions, but the result is not very good because it's the fake data we recorded ourselves. It's not real enough. We can't find those micro expressions. So we only get this result. And also we got some challenges in the visual signal processing, and because it has a very high requirement about the visual signals, we need high resolution, and we need the front face. And so for some video signals with low resolution, or especially in the face region or got head rotations, the result is not good. And also another challenge we meet is that how can we combine the audio output and the visual output? From the audio signals, we get the keywords. From the visual signals, we get the emotion. But how can we analyze those signals? How can we combine them with the... When should we know we should pay attention to some specific things? We know the people is sad for the moment. Should we pay attention to that? And so we need to do some work on that later. And I think our solution is that we can use some statistical approaches to combine those two modalities. Okay, thank you.